We now know the name of the man who tried to pet a tiger in Collier County and paid the price. Thanks for watching NBC2. I'm Peter Bush.
And I'm Kelly Burns. 48-year-old Ignacio Martinez is recovering from severe puncture wounds. Deputies say they could see tendons sticking out of both of his arms. Martinez lives in Lehigh Acres, but works at Wooten's Animal Sanctuary in Ochapee. He followed a coworker into the outer enclosure and stuck his hand into the cage to pet the tiger while a caretaker was feeding it. Martinez managed to get away, and the tiger wasn't hurt.
Wooten's Everglades Airboat Tours has been around for nearly 70 years. Take a look at how far south it is. It's past Everglades City, so it's definitely a drive for just about any visitor. NBC2's Sarah Metz talked to people who drove all the way there today to see big cats, only to be disappointed.
This is the second time in 3 months people in Collier County have tested their limits with a big cat. Wootwin's Airboats didn't open their animal exhibits today because of the attack. I spoke with someone who owns an animal sanctuary with tigers, and she tells me people need to stop underestimating these dangerous animals.
The tiger was not doing anything unusual whatsoever. The person being in the enclosure was the unusual thing.
Deputies say while a caretaker fed two tigers on Tuesday, Ignacio Martinez stuck his hand through the fence multiple times. Then one tiger bit him. Lisa Stoner with Forest Animal Rescue says it doesn't necessarily sound like the tiger was being aggressive.
People tend to break a lot easier than other tigers would. So if they were being possessive over food and there was another tiger there, they'd probably bite or swat and the other tiger would walk away or leave him alone and there would be no bloodshed. If they decide to bite or swat us, we immediately have bloodshed.
Stoner thinks the mauling was more of a warning.
Since they were able to stop it, it probably was more of a get away from my food or a play mauling, because if it was full on aggression, I don't see that anybody would have been able to stop it.
She says it doesn't matter how long you have had a tiger or trained with it. They are still wild animals, and they will always act that way.
Whether that tiger was being aggressive or whether that tiger was playing, the end result is the same.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy. I don't know. I'm happy to hear that everyone's alive and the tiger's even alive.
People tell me it was disappointing to see the tiger enclosure was closed off today, but it didn't stop them from making the trip. Reporting in Collier County, Sarah Metz, NBC2.